So now you have TalentLMS and you're ready to train your amazing employees. We're going to tell you how to build your first course in TalentLMS.
Welcome to the eLearning Partners channel. We are so happy that you're here. We're so happy that we are giving you a free masterclass that is linked below.
Right below.
All about if you want to create that amazing eLearning program that is
going to
be successful.
How to engage your learners.
Go down below and click on it. We'll see you there. Jumping into TalentLMS. Woo! How do you create a course? Obviously, there's a button that says courses.
So once you sign in, you're gonna either need to be signed in as an administrator or an instructor.
I want to say the instructor. All right, lads, I'm only gonna show you this once.
If you're signed in as a learner, you can't create courses. But if you're an administrator, here's what your dashboard looks like.
There's a big dash in the middle.
So what you're gonna do is you're gonna click on add a course.
Add a course.
And it's pretty simple. This is what opens up. And look, we've reached our active courses limit because we're on a free plan. Our demo account's showing you this. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna click on add a course. And here we go. We can add a course name, a category, a description, etc. So we're gonna call this the Hector is a Greek course.
This is why we love TalentLMS. It's very, very simple. It's easy to use and easy to understand. One of the biggest problems with a lot of other learning management systems out there is that they make it too complicated.
Exactly.
Very, very simple.
So what you can do is you literally name the course, we're naming it test, and then give it a category. So you can categorize or group your courses. Then you give it a description. And then you can say, is it active for your learners or is it hidden from the course catalog for your learners? And then we have a lot of other things that we can do. So we're going to go save it. And then we're going to see the users that are enrolled. But we're going to go back and go to course code. We can give it a code. We're going to say this is course HS 2020.
2020. All right. We're going back a couple of years.
We're going to give it a price. We're going to make it free.
30 grand.
Make it free because we're training our employees. Then we're gonna add an intro video. We can either drop a YouTube link or use a video that we upload.
Yep.
Capacity, we can say how many people can actually take the course, how many versions of this course are available, time options, how long do you have to start and finish the course,
certification. This is a big one.
You wanna give people a cert, and level. You can decide what skill level do you need. So you can actually like categorize your courses and then give them different levels.
Which is kind of cool. So if you have a department and within that department you have layers of levels, right? This is a great way to use that tool to help engage your learners, to encourage them to go from a level one sales rep to a level two sales rep or to a level three sales rep. So really cool way to utilize this platform.
Exactly. Then you can go and add users. So you can be like, I want this person, this person, this person. I'm gonna add all these people to my course. And really, at this point, you can go and add content. Multiple ways to add content. What you're gonna do is click on the add button, and here's all the different ways. You can just-
So many different ways, which is awesome.
Add simple content, which is you can give a unit a name, and then a question, period of time, same type of stuff. And you can custom build out your unit. This could be a video, text, you can embed stuff here, do a lot of different things.
Which is another reason why we love TalentLMS, because unlike other learning management systems out there, you need a separate authoring tool to create content that lives on the learning management system. The beautiful thing with TalentLMS is that, yes, you can use other softwares and then bring that content in like Adobe Captivate,
but you
can also build it within TalentLMS as well.
Yeah, you can add web content too. So we open this up and this allows you to just add specific websites that are already out there, so we're gonna have to recreate stuff, which is cool. You can add videos, audio, presentations. So here's where you can go and design a course in Rise, or you can design it in Captivate or another authoring tool, and bring in that SCORM or XAPI file or CMI5 file into TalentLMS and host it here, which is really cool. And then test, survey, assignment, all these other things. So that's how simple it is. Now, you are now logged in as an instructor once you are actually building out the content in the course. So the admin allows you to change the overall settings of the course. And then to actually build out the content of the course, you have to be logged in as an instructor. And then to view the course, you have to be logged in as a learner. So that's how you build a course in TalentLMS. thank you for being here. We have a whole playlist on TalentLMS, so definitely go check that out. And if you want to guarantee the success of your e-learning program or online course every single time and make sure that you are attracting the right learners and engaging your learners, check out our free masterclass. We'll see you there.
Boom.